Good morning, students. Now we are going to discuss a continuation of module number 2, that is obtaining a general solution of a given differential equation by using Cauchy's and Legendre linear equations. In this case, if we consider a differential equation in some specific forms involving a variable coefficients. Variable coefficients. As we discussed in previous cases, there we observed whatever the differential equation we got a constant coefficients. But now we are going to get a variable coefficients. If this is the case, then what to do? We can solve these differential equations by reducing them into a differential equation with constant coefficients. Means what we are doing? We are taking the differential equation of a variable coefficient that will be converted into a differential equation with constant coefficients by substituting some of the specific substitutions we are taking, some specific forms we are going to take. And we are going to discuss two things. One is Cauchy's linear equation. Second is Legendre's linear equation. So first we will be discussing Legendre linear equation. Then we'll come back to Cauchy's, because Cauchy's is a particular case of Legendre. Okay. So first we discuss Legendre linear equation. Let us see what it is. If we consider a second order differential equation in the form, if you write down second order linear differential equation in the form a naught into ax plus b square y double dash plus a1 into ax plus b y dash plus a2 into y is equal to pi of x. If this pi of x will be 0, then this is called as homogeneous differential equation. If this pi of x is non-zero, then it will be called as non-homogeneous differential equation, and this pi of x must be a function of x. Okay, what about this? So this is called as Legendre linear equation of second order. Okay. Then if you observe this case, what we are getting? Here we are getting few of the terms are going to be replaced by with substitution. Why it has to be replaced? We can see this is the differential equation with variable coefficients. We can see here AX term. So variable coefficient it is. So if it would be constant coefficient differential equation, would have solved by previous methods, whether it is a solution of homogeneous or it is a solution of non-homogeneous, type 1 where exponential comes, type 2 where trigonometry comes, type 3 where polynomial equation comes. Okay, but it is a variable coefficient. So what to do? For that we have to take a substitution. Substitution to be taken. What substitution we will be taking? And what for substitution will be taken? Substitution will be taken only to convert the things from a differential equation of a variable coefficient to differential equation of a constant coefficients. Okay. For that we take a substitution. T is equal to log of AX plus B. Or if you apply exponential on both sides, it becomes e raised to T is equal to exponential and logarithm, only ax plus b remains. This is the thing. Therefore, we know that dy by dx can be written as, we write it as dy by dx. And here we can observe t is also a variable now, parameter. Therefore, we take it as dy by dt into dt by dx. This is nothing but dy by dt into, what is dt by dx? T is already given. So differentiate this t with respect to a variable x. Then differentiation of logarithm is 1 divided by ax plus b. Then differentiation of this bracket with respect to x is a. So this is nothing but dy by dx. Therefore, if you shuffle the terms, if you take a cross multiplication, then we will be getting a into dy by dt is equal to ax plus b into dy by dx. Now we will be taking a few notations. What is that? Let us take capital D, which is nothing but d by dt. And this dy by dx will be taken as y dash. Then what we get? We will be getting a into dy is equal to d by dt is capital D is equal to ax plus b into y dash. Therefore ax plus b into y dash is equal to a into d of y. So this is one more term. So if we continue further, what we will be getting? We will be getting ax plus b the square into y double dash is equal to a into a, it will be a square, then d into next term is a d minus 1 of y. I call it as equation number 3. Then if you continue further, it will be ax plus b the cube into y triple dash is equal to a cube d into d minus 1 into d minus 2 of y, equation number 4. So like that we can continue. But as per equation number 1, what we need? We need ax plus b square y double dash, that is there. We need ax plus b into y dash, that is sufficient because it is a second order. It means this and this substitution is sufficient. Therefore, if we substitute all these things in equation number 1, then we will be getting equation number 1 as a naught into this ax plus b the whole square y double dash is what? That is a square into d of d minus 1 of y plus a1 into a dy plus a2 of y is equal to pi of x. Even in pi of x also it will be replaced. So I'll take pi dash. If we solve this, then we can see here we are getting a differential equation with constant coefficient. If it is so, then automatically we can obtain a general solution, which is a combination of complementary function plus particular integral. If it is a differential equation with a constant coefficient, then we can solve that by using previous methods. Okay, suppose if this is then I take next concept, that is Cauchy's linear equation. What do you mean by Cauchy's linear equation now? So Cauchy's linear equation is a particular case. Is a particular case of legendary equation. What is the case? What is the particular case? It is a particular case when a is equal to 1 and b is equal to 0 in equation number 1 if you substitute. Cauchy's linear equation is a particular case of Legendre linear equation where a is equal to 1 and b is equal to 0. And we can observe previously what was the result. The result was a naught into ax plus b the square y double dash plus a1 into ax plus b y dash plus a2 y is equal to pi of x. But here what happens? A is equal to 1, b is equal to 0. If you substitute this in equation number 1 of legendary, then it becomes a naught into x square y double dash plus a1 into x y double dash plus a2 of y is equal to phi of x. Okay, so this will be the linear equation which is called as Cauchy's equation. But again, we can observe here we are having variable as a coefficient for a differential equation. This has to be again converted into a differential equation with constant coefficient. For that, what to do? We have to go for a substitution again. What will be the substitution? Previously, in a previous case, that is legendary, what substitution we took? We took the substitution as t is equal to log of ax plus b. But what the condition says? A is equal to 1 and b is equal to 0. If so, then what it is? T is equal to log of x, or e raised to t is equal to x. Then whatever the substitutions we took, in that you substitute a is equal to 1 and b is equal to 0. Then we will be getting further x y dash is equal to dy, x square y double dash is equal to d into d minus 1 of y, because previously it was a square, but a is equal to 1. Next, x cube y triple dash is equal to d into d minus 1 into d minus 2 of y, and it will continue. So this will be the substitution. So two things we need to remember: how to convert a differential equation with variable coefficient into a differential equation with constant coefficient. If it is a Legendre equation, then substitutions are different. If it is Cauchy's linear equation, in the substitution we need to take care where a is equal to 1 and b is equal to 0. For this only it is a particular case of Legendre equations. Okay, now we do one thing, we'll take examples to solve. Okay, what is the example? In the example we need to understand the given equation is whether Cauchy's or Legendre. Okay, let us see. Example will be given like this: solve x square d square y by dx square minus 3x dy by dx plus 4y is equal to 1 plus x whole square. This question is from university model question paper. So very first, what to do? We need to write it like x square. D square y by dx square can be written as y double dash minus 3 times x into y dash plus 4y is equal to expansion of this. It is like a plus b whole square. So it is 1 plus x square plus 2x. Okay. So we call it as equation number 1. Then is it Cauchy's linear equation or Legendre linear equation? We need to understand. Okay. So if you look into this, then it is Cauchy's equation. If it would be Legendre, then it would be in the pattern of ax plus b as a coefficient. Here it is not there, only x square, x terms are there. Therefore, we go for a substitution. So put t is equal to log x, or e raised to t is equal to x. Then x y dash will be replaced by dy, and x square y double dash will be replaced by d into d minus 1 of y. Okay, substitute all, take all these substitutions in equation number 1, even in LHS, even in RHS. Then what happens? What is the replacement for x square y double dash? D into equation number 1 becomes d into d minus 1 of y minus 3 times. What will be the replacement for x y dash? Dy plus 4 into y is equal to 1 will be kept as it is. Then what is the replacement for x e raised to t? then what will be there for x square? E raised to t the square means e raised to 2t plus 2 times the replacement of x is e raised to t. Therefore, simplify this. Simplifying this condition. What is that? Now it is, you can see, d into d, d square minus d minus 3d plus 4 of y is equal to 1 plus e raised to 2t plus 2 into e raised to t. So this is d square minus 4d plus 4 of y is equal to 1 plus e raised to 2t plus 2 into e raised to t. Okay. So if you see this, I take it as equation number 2. If you see this equation, this is very quite familiar equation, well-known equation. So this is a differential equation with a constant coefficient, and we know how to solve this by using type 1. Okay, so let us solve this. Very first, I take it as auxiliary equation. It is a repetition of a previous methods only now. Then it becomes m square minus 4m plus 4 equal to 0. Therefore, if you solve this equation to get a roots, the value of m, we can see it is nothing but m minus 2 whole square, which is nothing but m is equal to 2 comma 2. Therefore, the complementary function is c1 plus t into c2, not x into, t into, because you can see the variable. In this case, what is the variable? In a previous given example, x is a variable. But after the substitutions, when we have modified this equation, now t becomes a variable. So that care to be taken. So c1 plus t into c2 e raised to 2t. This is our complementary function. Then what is required? Particular integral. What is particular integral? 1 plus e raised to 2t plus 2 times e raised to t divided by f of d, which is nothing but 1 by f of d plus e raised to 2t divided by f of d plus 2 times e raised to t divided by f of d. I call it as p1, p2 and p3. Okay, let us take one by one. First we take p1. What is p1? 1 divided by f of d. 1 is a constant, it is a number. Then how it is connected to exponential term? We take it as 1 into e raised to 0 times x divided by f of d. What is f of d? D square minus 4d plus 4, where d is going to be replaced by a, and that a is equal to 0. That a will be taken from exponential. Therefore, it is 1 divided by 0 minus 4 into 0 plus 4. That is equal to 1 by 4. This is p1. Next, p2. What is p2? P2 is nothing but e raised to 2t divided by f of d. So e raised to 2t divided by d square minus 4d plus 4, where d is going to be replaced by a, and a is equal to 2. If you replace this, then what happens? E raised to 2t divided by d square, sorry, replace d by 2. So it is 2 square minus 4 into 2 plus 4. Then what happens? 2 square will be 4 plus 4 will be 8 minus 8. So denominator becomes 0. If denominator becomes 0, then we need to proceed with next step. That is, multiply it by a variable t. Here variable is a t, into e raised to 2t divided by differentiation of the denominator with respect to d. That is 2d minus 4. Again, t into e raised to 2t divided by 2 into the value of a is 2 minus 4. Again, you can see the denominator becomes 0. If the denominator becomes 0, then what to do? Multiply one more t, then it becomes t square e raised to 2t divided by, differentiate this one, this denominator once again, then it becomes 2. Therefore, this is P2. Okay. Then we take P3. What is P3? P3 is 2 times e raised to t divided by f of d. That is equal to 2 into e raised to t divided by d square minus 4d plus 4. Here d being replaced by a, and that a is equal to 1. Therefore it is 2 into e raised to t divided by, replace d by 1. So it becomes 1 square minus 4 into 1 plus 4. Therefore this is equal to 2 into e raised to t divided by 4 plus 1, 5. 5 minus 4 will be 1. So it is 2 into e raised to t. This is P3. Therefore, Pi becomes P1 plus P2 plus P3. P1 plus P2 plus P3. That is equal to, what is P1? 1 by 4 plus P2. That is a t square into e raised to 2t divided by 2 plus P3 is 2 into e raised to t. This is Pi. Okay. Then what is general solution? General solution is complementary function plus particular integral. Therefore, y is equal to, what is complementary function? C1 plus t into C2 into e raised to 2t plus particular integral is 1 by 4 plus t square into e raised to 2t divided by 2 plus 2 into e raised to t. Then this becomes a general solution for this modified equation. For this modified equation number 2, but not for the given example. Then what to do? Whatever we got, it is a general solution for equation number 2, but we need a general solution for equation number 1. How we got equation number 2? Because of few substitutions in equation number 1. Then we got a general solution. How do you make this general solution, which will be the general solution for equation number 1? Then what to do? We have to re-substitute whatever the things we substituted in the beginning back to equation number 1. Okay? Therefore, but whatever substitutions we took, t is equal to log x we substituted. Then we got e raised to t is equal to x also we substituted. So this will be substituted back. Therefore, y is equal to c1 plus, what is t? Log x into c2 into e raised to 2t. E raised to t is x. So e raised to 2t will be x square plus 1 divided by 4 plus t square. T is nothing but log x. So t square will be log x square into e raised to 2t. That is nothing but x square divided by 2 plus 2 into e raised to t. E raised to t is nothing but x. So this will be the general solution for given equation number 1. I'll repeat the process once again. If this is the given differential equation, then what to do? We have to check it out whether it is Cauchy's or Legendre. This is Cauchy's. So take the substitutions as per Cauchy's. Then substitute all these things to get equation number 2. After getting equation number 2, we observed this is equation number 2 is a differential equation with a constant coefficient. We know how to solve this. So that we have taken. In auxiliary equation, we got a roots. Then based on the roots, we constructed complementary function. Then we calculated particular integral of type 1. P1, P2, P3 we got, and we substituted to get Pi. Then we substituted Pi along with the complementary function to get general solution. But this is the general solution for modified version, not for original example. So we re-substituted back. We substituted back the previous substitutions in this result. Then we got one result. This is the general solution for given differential equation. So this is the process. So go through the process and try to solve the example. Thank you.